this is Ron Strange and More. I'm over here in Knoxville, Tennessee, right off the strip Cumberland Avenue here. Got a CSX mixed freight sitting here waiting. Looks like it might be waiting on another one, or it's backing in the yard here. Looks like a couple ES44s and maybe a Jeep 38 on the rear. Got a mixed freight here, some grain hoppers, and yeah, it's a CSX's yard over here near on down the tracks past that bridge. There is Neyland Stadium, UT football stadium, and the basketball on around that curve down there. I believe he's waiting on another train here. I could be wrong. He backed up a little bit. I was thinking he could be back in the yard, but I believe this is just a road freight. I believe he's waiting on another. No, he's back in the yard, looks like. Anyways, I'll be quiet here and let y'all enjoy the video. Looking at them hoppers right there, kind of look like he's driving with them. Now he's moving forward. Boy, this is that slack action. I guess he's doing a little yard work here. I'm not really sure, to tell you the truth, over here in the yard in Knoxville. I'll walk up here by the locomotive and see if I can get a shot of the engines here. Number 2640. Are y'all switching cars? I guess it'd be okay if I film, huh? All right. Is there another train coming? All right. Catch him a little bit switching cars here. I don't know if he's going to back that whole train up, but looks like he might be going to maybe switch a few cars here. They got a pretty good little rail yard right down there. He's throwing the switch here, so he must be going to back up here. Backing up, looks like. We're back up in the yard here. Sitting here. There's a placard there. 1973. Anybody knows what that means, let me know in the comments. I'd be kind of curious what that thing's hauling. It's obviously flammable. Methanol or ethanol. some kind of fuel maybe, but I don't think he's loaded. Boy, that fire action, man, it always gets me. I'm sure all them brakes on them cars are open though. He's using the chain brakes. I think he did. I'd like to get a shot of them locomotives he backs on down through here. Walk on up through here just a little bit here, maybe. Might see if I can get a quick shot of the locomotives right quick. Sorry about the little bit of the shakiness of the camera. I'm trying to film and walking on the railroad ballast. Don't really mix too well. But it's fun. I love recording this train. Fun hobby. I'd recommend anybody to get into this hobby. Model trains or rail fans or anything like that. It's just a fun hobby all around. That looks like one of them car detector things right there. It reads those little cards on the side of the car, and they can track the car anywhere in the U.S. where it's at and see what it's hauling and everything like that. How much it weighs, probably the length of it and everything. Kind of cool how they do that. I think it's called an AI or reader or something like that, tag reader. Slack up them cars. Might have dropped off them rear cars there, I don't know. There's a railroad right down below here where I'm filming also right here. Y'all can see the crossing down there. That's the Holston River Railroad. That's the tourist line you can ride here in Knoxville. Yeah, I'm trying to remember the name of it. Right now I can't really remember the name of it, but yeah, it's just a little tourist line you can ride. Sometimes they use steam, and they have used the old Southern number 630, and I think even 4501's run little tourist trains through here. But I don't think they're running it right now because of that COVID-19. I'll more than likely end up riding that one day though. I'll be for sure to do a video on it. I think they're building some kind of a new structure over here in Knoxville. They got one of them big cranes right there. That's kind of cool. I don't believe I'd want to climb that thing, but it's still kind of cool. Yeah, I got a little thing about heights, you know. I believe I'll stay away from that crane. Yeah, it's supposed to be a pretty good little tourist line right down there. They got a little depot and a little switch engine out there. Supposed to go over the big Knoxville bridge over here, and it goes on around. I'm not really sure of its route, but it's supposed to be a pretty nice little ride. We got a lot of open air cars and a few others. I think they even have dinner on there. I'll ride that one in Etowah, Tennessee one of these days, at Copper Hill loop train. I always wanted to do that. If I ever do that, I'll be sure to do a video on it also. Well, looks like we made it up to the locomotives here. Might film them a little bit here, maybe, before they take off again. Yeah, we got a Jeep 38 here in the back, number 2640. Looks like two ES-44s. No, one ES-44. That one in the front looks like a Dash 9 C-44. Now we got Jeep 38 number 2640 here. GS 44 number 758 and